you launch a LinkedIn newsletter and a few tips to go with it. I have a newsletter on LinkedIn. It's called Q&A with Shanae, and I currently have over 216,000 subscribers to my newsletter. Now, that said, this is how you actually launch a newsletter. The first step is to go to your LinkedIn news feed. The second step is to click article. Then at the top, you're going to see an area that says create a newsletter. Now, when you're titling your newsletter, you want to be very specific to your prospect. If I wanted to launch a newsletter for plumbers, then I would say Plumbers Anonymous, For Plumbers Only, Q&A for Plumbers and Contractors, something like that, where you would have no reason to subscribe if you were not a plumber. Therefore, you would have no reason to subscribe if you were not my ideal prospect. Now, the downside of the LinkedIn newsletter is that you don't get their emails when they subscribe. It's not like you're building your private email list with the newsletter. However, there are ways for you to monetize and get those emails depending on your business model. If you, for example, have 1,000 subscribers on your LinkedIn newsletter, and then within that newsletter, you include a call to action to your consultation, and your content is actually great, they will want to schedule consultations. Let's say you have 1,000 subscribers. Every single week, you send out a newsletter. Every single week, 5 people schedule a consultation, and you close 2 of those clients. If your average price for whatever it is that you sell is $1,000, that means that that's $2,000 a week. And that's just from that newsletter. And I was keeping the numbers very, very conservative. If your content's really good and your consultations are really good, obviously those numbers can look a little bit different. So I guess the first question that you want to ask yourself is like, where do you want to drive this traffic? I was talking to a friend earlier today, and she doesn't really have a business model based on consultations. She is monetizing her YouTube channel. So what she's going to do, she has around 30,000 followers on LinkedIn. When she launches her LinkedIn newsletter, she'll have within a couple weeks about 10,000 subscribers. And then a percentage of those subscribers every single week when a newsletter is released, leveraging her previous YouTube content, is going to go to her YouTube. She's going to get views and she's going to further monetize her channel. Obviously, a percentage of those will turn into loyal subscribers, followers, you know, super fans, and then clients. Where do you want to drive traffic? This depends on your business model. It could be a consultation, it could be a free webinar, it could be a free challenge, it could be a downloadable ebook. Whatever it is, you need to have one clear place where people are going to go. And you need to have hyperlinks and call to actions within your newsletter very seamlessly for people to go there. Once you have that place, you obviously want to test it out and be consistent. Don't launch a newsletter unless you're being consistent. And I hope that helps. You know, keep it simple, keep it fresh, test a few things, but this is how you launch your LinkedIn newsletter. I don't care if you have 5,000 followers or even 1,000 followers on LinkedIn. What do you have to lose by reaching more people in a way that could help them?